Hello, friends. I like to call this emotional agriculture. One of nature's classroom's lessons that I use in my own life. I refer to relationships as emotional agriculture, farming crops and nature's outdoor classroom life lessons. The included image is a visual metaphor for love or the alternative emotional drought. Both can be moments away. Some people are sensitive enough to perceive when emotions require water, sunlight, and fertilizer, and they cherish and nourish the emotions with affirmations, validations, and reciprocity. They in turn receive an excellent harvest of great beauty and abundance. Others plant an emotional crop and then watch it wither and die. Crops need frequent daily attention and love, not only the rare visit from an emotional thunderstorm. Emotional crops require weeding and excellent communication of needs, wants, and passions to thrive. Many crops do not make their needs obvious, and many do not fully understand what those unique needs may be. It takes patience and interest for the emotional farmer to get to know and cherish the crops and assist them in unlocking their special uniqueness and specific growth formula. Some emotional farmers will provide the bare minimum of effort, and it always shows in their harvests. Others will go beyond all expectations because it is their passion to nourish and inspire their love crops to thrive daily. We all have a choice. May you continue to grow and radiate and be the sunshine, water, and fertilizer for an abundance of spectacular harvests in yourself and others.